92.1 WROI, WROIFM.com, and RTC Channel 5. We're streaming audio there. And soon to have audio and video on RTC Channel 4. Dakota's here. Hey, good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
All right. If you make a few more trips, you get your own coffee cup. So
awesome.
Stay right with it, all right? Brian Johnson here from the Fulton County Community Foundation, part of the Northern Indiana Community Foundation. Brian, good morning.
Good morning, Tom. I'm still working on getting my own coffee cup down here, so.
You've got a couple.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's good to know. Maybe
we'll get you all set up.
On a cool morning like this, it might be a good thing to have that warm cup of coffee. So
busy times for the foundation.
Well, hey, it is a busy time. This is end of year, and that gets very busy. So we'll talk a little bit about some of the details for that. Just wanted to do a couple of reminders. Women's Giving Circle members, just a reminder to get your dues in by the end of the year. They're $120 annually, and that group has given out, and since 2011 has given out over $45,000 to support local projects. One that was kind of neat this last month, we saw information about the Tippecanoe Valley Unified Sports Flag Football Team.
Exactly.
Champions Together program came in as runner-up in the state. Congratulations to that group of students and coaches and everybody involved with that. That was one program that the Women's Giving Circle granted to this last year. So exciting to see the success. But those, like I said, those dues are due in by December 31st of this year, $120 annually. If you have questions about that, by all means, don't hesitate to give us a call. We have information on our website, nicf.org, where you can find out a little bit more about that organization. So talking about things coming up. It seems too early to mention this, but it's almost time for scholarship applications to be available.
Oh, wow.
So December 1st, our applications will be available on our website.
Okay.
I'd encourage students, we have about 45 different scholarships that support anything from specific fields of study to things folks have been involved in. It's neat to see how our community supports our future generations. And, of course, college isn't getting any cheaper these days. And so
you'll find out one of these
days. Yes. The financial help helps, but it's also neat to see how these scholarships can be encouragement to students and say, we as a community believe in you. We want to help you be able to make that next step in your education career. So kind of exciting to see that going on. So December 1st, those applications will be available. So if you're watching this on RTC after December 1st, you'll be able to go to our website, nicf.org, and look at the scholarship pages and look at the scholarships that are available and start working on that. Those applications will be due the first part of March. So students have quite a bit of time to do that, but they do require different scholarships, require some different pieces like letters of recommendation or information about specific things you've been involved in. So take a look at that and kind of get a plan together for how you're going to work on that. So something else, we mentioned the Women's Giving Circle. A couple years ago, some of the mothers that were involved in the Women's Giving Circle got together and said, well, we'd like to have something similar for our daughters to be involved in. So the idea of what has been named the Girls Giving Gang came about. And this is a group for girls 18 and under that do similar to what the Women's Giving Circle does. It's really more about education and kind of getting our future generations in the idea of philanthropy and how things come about in our
Excellent
community.
Excellent idea.
So this year we had our second social with that. We held that on October 30th at the library. The girls had a lot of fun. Part of what they do is decorate. This year they chose to decorate some CDs. I have boys, so I'm not familiar with glitter, but I was finding glitter for 3 or 4 days around places. But they had a lot of fun decorating some CDs that were then turned into Christmas ornaments and then donated to residents at Hickory Creek. I think the girls had as much fun as the residents had receiving those. Also were able to make some blankets for the animal shelter as they adopt cats out. They hand out blankets, and so that's always a popular thing. And then in addition to that, they did some granting. The Community Foundation the last couple of years has provided funds for the girls to be able to make grants in the community. This year they had $2,000 and they were able to grant to four different organizations, $500 each. Kind of neat, as the girls come in, they suggest organizations to be nominated to receive funds, and then towards the end of the meeting, all the girls that are members vote on which organizations receive that. And it's neat to see some of the ideas. So this year, these are all ideas that came from the girls and then were voted on by the girls.
Okay.
Four organizations: Riley's Children's Hospital. I have a lot of friends and neighbors that have benefited from that incredible organization. The Girls on the Run program at the Rochester Elementary and Middle Schools, a program that helps encourage girls build some life skills, teach them some running skills. Rochester also has a Champions Together program at the middle school, and they are receiving a $500 grant. And then also the Rochester Middle School has a food pantry that developed out of a weekend backpack program and has now become a full-grown food pantry at the middle school, and helps families that may need some help with some short-term food needs. So those four organizations were nominated. I think we had about 10 organizations that were nominated by the girls.
Okay.
It's really neat when you see anywhere from, I think the youngest we had was 5, all the way up to 18 years old that evening. Coming in and really thinking about, well, what am I involved in and what needs support? And it's really neat to see some of the ideas that us as adults wouldn't necessarily think of. And these young ladies are really thinking about it and thinking, oh, this is a good thing for our community.
They got to feel good about that, too, after they do those grants.
They do, and it's a lot of fun to hear the discussions going on and conversations about, oh, I'm involved in this, and I've seen this happen, and this is a result, and this is what good has come out of that. So kind of exciting. So with that group, what we've done is we have a membership for that, which is $12 per year. So kind of modeled after the Women's Giving Circle.
Dollar a month
versus $10 a month. We had a lot of discussion about how that would go, and some of the moms said, well, if our daughters have some funds, we'd really like them to be able to afford to pay for their dues if that's something they would like to do every year. Kind of teaches them about philanthropy and how things come about. So kind of neat to see how that group has kind of taken on a life of its own, and you get young ladies involved in this, and it's fun. You can kind of step back and get out of the way, and they know what to do. So, but thank you to everybody who's involved in that. If mothers and daughters have questions about that, we'd love to talk to you about how to get involved with that. Stephanie Barkman has been the chair of that committee. I'm sure she would love to talk to you more about that group if you're interested. But thank you to everybody who participated in that, and the mothers and the daughters, and it was fun this year. We had a couple of girls in high school that really helped plan and organize this event, and wonderful to see future generations really taking charge of things like that. So neat to see. So, well, it's almost Thanksgiving.
Almost.
I was thinking about the saying about frost on the pumpkins. I looked out the front window this morning, and there was actually snow on the pumpkins.
Right.
I'm not sure which season that would be, but wonderful to see that. Talking about pumpkins, of course, the Optimist Club is our pumpkin group here in the community.
Right. Nice grant, by the way.
Kind of exciting. We're able to grant. They have the opportunity to purchase the land where their pumpkin stand has been for the last few years. We're able to help grant a part of that, a $20,000 grant to help them purchase that property, create a permanent location. Who would have thought that pumpkins would be so popular in our community? But the pumpkins I was looking at this morning came from the Optimist Club, set up outside our office. And just a wonderful group that does so much in our community. So congratulations to the Optimist Club. Keep up the good work
The
pumpkins. And so it's exciting to be able to help support organizations that are doing so much in our community with grants like this. Another big thing that happens in November is Thanksgiving. And then we have this series of things. We have Thanksgiving. Then I'm sure you're probably up at 4 or 5 on Friday morning to do your Black Friday shopping. And then
A lot of folks are, though.
They are. And then you have the Small Business Saturday, a wonderful way to support local small businesses. And then everybody spends Monday shopping online on Cyber Monday. Well, the effort has come out a few years ago in the world of philanthropy for Giving Tuesday. And this is going to be another chance for us to celebrate Giving Tuesday. We've done this the last few years. So Tuesday, November 27th, that's the first Tuesday after Thanksgiving, is really a day focused on giving back. This is something, like I said, has been a worldwide effort for a few years. We've celebrated, this will be our fourth year doing it. Kind of exciting, we'll have our office open. We open at 8, and we'll be open until 6 p.m. that day. I'd encourage folks to stop by, kind of an open house, learn about some of the things that we've done throughout the year, learn about some of the opportunities that are going on. We'll have lunch from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. We'll have treats throughout the day, but if you need lunch, stop by somewhere between 11 and 2. We'll have some good food. We'll have WROI made a little bit of change. You'll be live from at our office from 11 to noon.
Looking forward to it.
Looking forward to that. You can stop by, make your year-end gift, or just find out what the foundation has been doing throughout the year. We also have some exciting matching opportunities for community funds, so I'll leave it at that. But you won't want to miss that opportunity as well.
Maybe by then you'll be able to say more about
it. We'll be able to say a little bit more about that and be able to tell you about how your gift will be more than doubled. So wonderful to see that going on, opportunities for community fund gifts. If you have questions about that, you can kind of check out our Facebook page and see a little bit more about that. But just a wonderful time to kind of celebrate what we've done in the community, what our community, we talk about our community being a giving community, and that just plays out over and over again. We see needs come up, and those needs are met, and it's wonderful to see how our community has supported itself.
You know, you talk about that, and it's a nice day to walk in, and you usually have a video going showing a lot of the things that you have granted over the past year. And the foundation does, I think, a lot more than meets the eye, and that's really a good time to find out about that.
And it's just kind of a wonderful reminder to sit down and look at some of the things that we've done throughout the past year and just to be encouraged, and sometimes that spurs ideas. I know it's been interesting as we look at our grant applications throughout the year. We've been able to fund a large part of those grant applications just because our community has been so generous. Our previous Lilly matches have really been successful, has allowed us to grant in the past few years. Our granting has grown from about $100,000 to almost $200,000 this year. And it's just wonderful to kind of see, when you're in the middle of it, you say, oh, we've made this grant, we've made that grant. But then when we start looking at the dollars and cents and the impact that has been made, and we're going to talk a little bit about pop-up grants that we've made, but it's neat to kind of see that as a whole together and be able to see some of the things that have happened.
Exactly.
So like I said, I invite folks, Giving Tuesday, November 27th. We'll be open from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. If you can't make it, you can give online, nicf.org, and you can find the donate button right on the homepage and make a year-end gift and look at some of the things that we've done.
Okay, good.
So and again, this year is our 25th anniversary, so we're celebrating some of those things going on as well. So just wanted to put a plug in for year-end giving.
Okay.
A lot of folks are looking at tax implications for the end of the year. Of course, a gift to charity can help reduce some of those and actually save some money in some cases. I would encourage folks to talk with your financial planner or accountant on that to kind of see how that would affect what your tax bill would be. One thing that we've had a wonderful opportunity is IRA rollovers. Of course, when folks hit 70 and a half years old, if they have a traditional IRA, they have what's called a required minimum distribution. Donors now have the opportunity to roll that straight over into a a fund at the Community Foundation if they so choose, if they don't need that distribution, because if they don't need it, they have to take it anyway and has income tax implications. But this rollover opportunity has been a really neat way to meet that required minimum distribution and also not have to pay taxes on it.
Excellent.
So there's all kinds of ways to be able to look at reducing that tax burden and also benefiting something in our community. So encourage folks to think a little bit about that. Well, I just wanted to talk a little bit throughout this year. Last year, as we started talking about how we celebrate our 25th anniversary, we say, well, we're an organization that gives money away. So what better way to celebrate things going on in our community than to give money away?
Sure.
So the idea of pop-up grants.
The whole idea, right?
We said, we don't want organizations to have to apply for anything. We want to be able to say thank you to these organizations serving our community, encourage them. And, oh, by the way, we're bringing a check, which nobody has said, no, we don't really want that. That always helps a little bit. But really, it's about celebrating all the good things that we have in our community. So I'm just going to run down the list of organizations that have received pop-up grants. And like I said, this was really to recognize these organizations, the impact that they're making, and celebrate some of the things that we have in our community. So we actually started last fall with some pop-up grants. We gave some grants to the Fraternal Order of Police, Shop with a Cop program. United Ministries every year does their Christmas basket program, provided some funding for that. The free meal, a collaboration between three or four local churches every Wednesday night. Of course, Grace United Methodist has spearheaded that with the use of their facility and a number of things, so we're able to support that. We also were able to help the Miracle Tree program that Mill Creek Missionary Church has spearheaded in our community. And then starting this year, able to support some organizations. Scioto's Eye had a national convention here. We were able to support. If you saw this summer, they had some wonderful banners that were part of an art project with local elementary and high school students. Manitow Training Center, an important facility in our community for helping folks with some sort of development needs. The Abenabi Township Improvement Corporation, of course, a group working out in Leiters Ford, has been around for a while and does some really great things in that community to help with community development. And then we got into springtime and we said, what better way to support our community than to support local youth leagues?
Absolutely.
So we have organizations like the Kiwanis Youth League was revitalized this year. Thank you to all the folks that were involved in getting that up and going. The first year of the group, and they had over 50 kids that signed up to play for the first year. A lot of fun. Rochester Girls Softball League playing out at Blackadder Sports Complex. Wonderful organization. Rochester Youth Baseball playing down in the city park. Akron Youth League. Of course, Akron has both a baseball program and a softball program. A wonderful organization. And then the Caston Athletic League. And again, another organization that provides opportunities for both baseball and softball. So it was very fun. I mean, my family has benefited personally from a couple of these organizations. Exciting to see how they continue to grow and continue to be such an important part of our program. It's fun to watch kids learn an activity, but also learn things like sportsmanship.
Absolutely, sure.
How to work as a team and how to get along with others. So then we moved into the summer. Camp We Can was a recipient of a pop-up grant. Of course, an organization that has done so much. It's amazing to see how that organization has grown and provides so much support, not only for students, but just families in general.
Such great experiences for those people.
It is, and it's really neat to hear the stories of students say, well, I've never been able to do this, and all of a sudden,
you can.
We've made the arrangements so that you can do this. CASA of Fulton County, such an important advocate for young children in our community who may not be dealing with the best situation, but to have an adult come alongside and say, can I help you? Can I be a support for you? What do you need? Another program serving youth, the Rochester Parks Department, the Summer Park Program. Mm-hmm. A wonderful opportunity for kids to experience different things in our community. course, where would we be without libraries? So exactly. This summer, during the summer reading program, thank you to the libraries for providing those. We're able to provide pop-up grants to the Fulton County Public Library as well as the Akron-Carnegie Library. Keep up the good work to both of those organizations. 4th of July, what do we think about on 4th of July? We think about Akron and the founding, and that group puts on such a wonderful time that so we were able to provide a grant to the 4th of July committee.
Okay.
Summertime, what do you think of summertime? The fair.
Absolutely.
4-H, we were able to provide a pop-up grant to 4-H and all that organization does for our community. Looking at some things like seniors, the Council on Aging has an RSVP program. So many things get done by volunteers with a smile on their face. We were able to provide a grant to them and also to the Council on Aging for some of the programs that they do. You go over there at lunchtime during the week and you see how many folks are benefiting from a meal there, and just enjoying the company is really the biggest thing. And then we get through July and we think about, well, it's time to go back to school, whether the kids want to or not. We have a wonderful organization. Fulton County Pack a Backpack has worked so hard to help provide school supplies for families and students who may not be able to afford that. We were able to provide them a pop-up grant. And then once we're back in school, I'm kind of trying to work in some themes here. So back in school, one thing that's been big lately is hands-on learning and robotics programs. So we were able to provide pop-up grants to the Caston School Corporation. They have a wonderful grade and middle school robotics program. And then also the Rochester High School for so many years has been doing a robotics program. Really neat to see the success that those organizations have benefited from. So just this year, we were able to provide $23,000 in pop-up grants. And I hear rumor we may have one more before the end of the year.
Good.
Last year, we were able to also provide about $6,500 in pop-up grants. So it's a very fun thing to be able to call an organization, say, hey, we have a surprise for you. We'd like to stop by. And oh, by the way, we may have a check for you.
Yeah, that's right.
But just to encourage these organizations that provide so many valuable services, we often don't think about where would we be without these organizations, without the volunteers.
They do a lot of good, don't they?
Do these. And so it's wonderful to be able to celebrate these organizations, be able to give them some encouragement and a thank you, to say thank you for what you do for our community. And a large part of why we're able to celebrate this was because our community has been so generous and allowed us to have funds to be able to grant out from our community funds to be able to support these organizations. So kind of fun to look back and see where we've been throughout the past year and how these organizations have been integral in our community. So
exciting to look ahead, too.
Exciting to look ahead.
You bet.
So, well, as we wrap up, just a quick reminder, scholarship applications coming up December 1st. Giving Tuesday, November 27th, starting at 8, going till 6 p.m. that evening. Give us a call if you can't make it that day. Find out about the exciting matching opportunity that, I guess, in the radio business, we'd say more details
stay
come
tuned.
Soon.
Stay tuned
for more details.
Exactly.
We'll have some exciting things going on with that as well. And year-end giving. I encourage folks to consider that as well as you're looking at tax planning and maybe how you can make an impact in our community. So, well, if you have questions about anything we talked about today, you can find us online, nicf.org. Like us on Facebook, nicf.org. Or actually, we're Northern Indiana Community Foundation.
Okay.
And we try and keep information updated there. Give us a call, 224-3223, or stop by our new office at 227 East 9th Street here in Rochester. We'd love to talk about any ideas, answer questions, help you make an impact in our community.
Giving Tuesday would be the perfect time to stop by.
Giving Tuesday would be the perfect time.
Bet.
You can celebrate. If you're not full from Thanksgiving, you can have some treats that day. If
Excellent.
You are full from Thanksgiving, you can make a year-end donation and benefit our community. So,
Brian Johnson, as always, thank you very much. Keep up the good work.
Well, thank you, Tom.
Have a nice Thanksgiving yourself.
Yes, we'll look forward to seeing everybody on Giving Tuesday.
Okay.